So, what is this about here?
This one is called The Capture. And this is where they got my mom so that she could be tied up in a straitjacket. Oh, this is my grandmother when they took her away in the paddy wagon. She just started screaming and crying, really screaming of pain because they took her only daughter away. And then there was left many.
And that was you holding her, hugging her?
Yeah, that was me holding her, hugging her, and I felt the pain that she was going through. You just couldn't help it. It was a scream that, I don't know, I cannot explain it. It's like a death. You know, when a person loses someone, it's that, that's what I put to portray that. Like when I painted that, it was like a relief. I don't know. It just felt, you know, it came out. That's what I felt.
Yeah, funny.
This one is.
That's very cute.
Yeah, where my grandma would bring this bucket in, but she'd always wash it and clean it. But it's my sister was very delicate, so as soon as she saw that bucket, I call it the pee bucket. She would jump out of the tub because she didn't want that bucket water to, she didn't want it on her.
What's this?
And this is called the broom. This is where my mom would leave the kids. I mean, she had, one was a year, one was 3 years, one was 4 years maybe. Juanita was a baby. And she would go and sit under a tree, sometimes I put her naked. I just put her naked. You know what I'm saying? And my grandma would come with a broom to tell her to go in the house. That your kids need you. You know, and because she didn't know what was going on in my mom's brain. She didn't know my mom was sick.
Right.
And this one is called, I think, The Capture. Where they finally got my mom, and they put her on a straitjacket, and that was really a painful thing. See, now my sister Emily saw her be put in the straitjacket. Me, I was with my grandma holding her, you know. So it kind of goes with that big story, you know, that I painted big. So I used to do the little ones first, and then I could do the more colorful ones, right?
Right.
Okay, now this is where they really strapped her. They strapped her down, and then they put her in this little paddy wagon right here. See? You could kind of see her little face. Can you see her little face?
Yeah,
And that's when all the crying and of my grandma started screaming and, you know, and all the pain. Yeah, it was a big pain there. And this one, too, this one I did in Farva's class. See? It's kind of, you see how it's...
Is that your mom?
That's how loose I was. So with...
That's great.
It doesn't even matter that it looks like your mom. It's just a...
Yeah.
A being.
That's my self-portrait. I did in a class.
There's a face there.
Oh, yeah. And that's, I don't know, it's one
crying.
Of the... Crying. Yeah, it's a tears.
Yeah.
It's a tearjerker.
Okay.
Love these. I love the colors that these came out, and that's that gouache. That's
on canvas.
Gouache. No, on paper. But you know, they're still bright.
Yeah.
They still look bright. This is the story of where my grandma sent me away to be with my father. Right. And I met him at my aunt's, and then we went to the bus depot. And I had a red onion sack where my grandma put my clothes in. Wasn't much in there. And my dad wouldn't carry it. He made me carry it.
He doesn't sound like he was liberated.
Guy. No, he wasn't liberated.
Not liberated.
And this is one, my grandma hanging clothes. Healing, shall I tell you the story?
Sure.
Okay, so this man, he came, he was walking crooked. And the doctors had told him he would never walk straight. Well, my grandmother was a healer, and she did something to his back. I mean, she worked on it maybe a month or so until he was walking straight. And he was so grateful. He brought us pitchers of milk, big tin cans of milk and meat, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how my... Because it was a hard living in those times, you know. So that was appreciated. And this is like my mom here. You see my mom there?
Mm-hmm.
And just the imagination of her, her sitting down by the tree.
Mm-hmm.
See, you know how I did the big one, the broom?
Yeah.
A similar to it.
So she had to live in an institution until she was 94? Where did she live?
She, you mean when she had...
Well, she lived to be 94, you said.
Oh, no, right? Me? I took her out when I was 17 years old.
Oh, okay.
And then I had to put her back in because the lady said, you know, that it was affecting my children. Because, she, schizophrenic.
Mm-hmm.
And so it was, and so then she went back in, then she came out, and then my sisters got older. I had her most, maybe like a few years, and then since my sisters got older, we all took care 6 months at a time.
I got it.
And that was nice, because you got the little relief, you know, and that was good, so...
And here's the broom again.
And here's the broom again, in different colors, right?
Mm-hmm.
Which is good, right?
Yeah, it's beautiful.
You have to repeat sometimes, and because it's a good thing, and you get better at it when you repeat, I think. And this is the same. I start with the same theme, and it just comes out different, you know. This, at the holidays, you know, Christmas, we'd always have my aunt, uncles and that come over and they'd play the guitar, and my grandma played the guitar, and my mom would dance, the Spanish dance, you know, the jotas, and it was just a good time at those times.
So your mother was from Spain?
Yeah, my mother was born in Spain.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Yeah, all of them. She was little when she came just from Spain. And so was my dad little, too. Yeah.
So somebody told me you were related to Frederico Lorca. Is that true?
I think so, because my grandpa was a Lorca, right, from the...
Uh-huh.
And they used to talk about it, you know, that they had a famous cousin that was a poet, did poetry. Then how he went to New York and everything, and how he was against the government, the revolution. He put plays out against the government, you know, and they don't like that there. But I love to paint, so that's my out, is my painting, you know. It puts you in a different place,
different perspective. I just love it. I mean, I'm happy I have this. It's, you know, it's like a child.
Tells you stories, right?
Yeah.